What's going on, Buff Nation? It's your boy Julian Campos, and I'll be presenting today's announcements. So let's get started. I don't want to waste your time. I don't want to make this announcement very lengthy, so I'm just going to keep this short and sweet. So of course, hopefully, if you're interested in taking dual credit classes, you've already taken your DSI testing. Today was for those whose last name starts with N and, you know, towards the end of the alphabet. If you did not take your test, whether or not because you didn't make it or you're an online student, please contact your counselor immediately so you can figure stuff out for that if you're still interested in taking dual credit classes next year. In addition to that, if you are interested in trying out for cheer, those packets and forms are actually due this Friday. With snowmageddon occurring last week, a lot of things got extended, so you have until Friday, February 26th, to turn in your forms. So please do that immediately. Well, that's about it for today, folks. Thank you and have a great day, and go Buffs!
House will be extending the application due date to Monday, March 1st at 3 p.m. Come by room 127 and pick up an application.
You might be wondering what PALS is all about.
PALS is all about leading and mentoring.
We go to elementary schools and volunteer in classrooms and mentor students.
We also help with homecoming decorations and volunteer at many events within our community.
For example, we volunteer at the Parade of Lights in Fort Worth.
If you are interested, don't lose your chance to apply.
Hey Buffs! So this week and next week we are doing Pennies for Patients,
benefiting the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society.
Our goal is to raise up to $1,000.
And the fifth period class with the largest donation wins a pizza party.
Go Buffs!
Hey Buffs! On Wednesday the 17th,
stop by the cafeteria to get a flyer if you don't know what to do and offer a new vehicle. Bye.
Hey Buffs, I'm Adriana.
And I'm Emily.
And we want you to join the dance department. In the dance department, you get a PE and a fine arts credit, and we have three performances a year.
It's a great experience to be a part of, and more than just a class, it's something to be involved in. It's a lot of fun, and we hope you join us next year.
Thank you.
This is Mr. Reed again, coming back to you with another friendly reminder. In commemorating Black History Month, now it's an opportunity to wear your paraphernalia that you may have that reflects or highlights African-American individuals, the history, culture, or even events. Thursday, this is only for faculty and staff treat. This is a Black Greek paraphernalia day. So all those omegas, alphas, deltas, kappas, sigmas out there, let's represent, let's sport that paraphernalia. And for the rest of us, there are non-Greek students, we will have another round of wearing famous African Americans. On Friday, to close it out, we're going to represent by sporting those HBCU schools. So if you have those HBCU paraphernalia, let's rock it. Now, if you have no paraphernalia at all to represent this Black History Week, that's okay. You can show some love and your support by just wearing something solid black, such as a solid black shirt or solid black pants, as a representative of solidarity or strength. That is all for now. Have a fine, buff day.
Hi, my name is Deja Cooper. Today's little known Black History Fact is Maya Angelou. Maya Angelou was born Margaret Johnson in St. Louis, Missouri on April 4th, 1928. She grew up in St. Louis, Stamps, Arkansas. She was an author, poet, historian, songwriter, playwright, dancer, stage and screen producer, director, performer, singer, and civil rights activist. She was best known for several books, one of them, I Know, by the Caged Bird Sings, was nominated for a National Book Award. With that publication, Angelou publicly discussed aspects of her personal life. She was respected as a spokesperson for Black people and women, and her works have been considered a defense of Black culture. Her works are widely used in schools and universities worldwide, although attempts have been made to ban her books from some U.S. libraries. In 1958-59, at request of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Angelou became the Northern coordinator for the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. Angelou wrote and delivered a poem on the pulse of the morning at the inauguration for President Bill Clinton at his request. Did you know in 2000 she received the National Medal of Arts, and then in 2011 she was awarded a Presidential Medal for Freedom by President Barack Obama. She was also the first Black woman director in Hollywood. This concludes your moment in Black history.
Hello, my name is Tyreek Hill. Today's little known Black history fact is George Washington Carver. George Washington Carver was an African-American scientist and educator. Carver is famous for many inventions, including a number of use for the peanut. George Washington Carver was born enslaved and went on to become one of the most prominent scientists and inventors of all of his time. He was a teacher at Tuskegee Institute and one of the most famous African-Americans of his time. Carver devised over 100 products of using one major crop, the peanut. Carver achieved international fame in political and professional circles. President Teddy Roosevelt admired his work and sought his advice in agricultural matters and the United States. Carver used his celebrity to promote scientific causes for the remainder of his life. Did you know George Washington Carver was the first African American to have a national monument and also known as the Peanut Man, but did not invent peanut butter? This concludes your moment in Black history.
Please stand for the pledges and moment of silence. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now for the Texas flag. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Please remain standing for a moment of silence.